Hey guys, welcome back to the Tegiwa YouTube channel. Today, you might be able to see that we're testing some horns for the GR Yaris. We have four horns here from PIAA. They range from £44 to just under £50. We've got Matt with us again. Thank you, Matt, for coming down with your Yaris. What do you think today's going to go like?
Yeah, well, obviously it's not the most exciting group test we've done on my Yaris, I think it's fair to say. But arguably, I think it's one of the most necessary ones. It's a really common complaint about the Yaris and lots of Japanese cars, that they just have a pathetic little horn. And I've got to be honest, I don't feel that it conveys how angry I am most of the time when I beep it. So it desperately needs upgrading. So there's a bigger range than I thought there would be. So we've got deeper ones down here, 330 and 400 hertz. So these are dual tone horns, so we've got one slightly deeper than the other. So that's why your German BMW, Volkswagen, they have a much louder, deeper, sort of manlier, if I can say that, sound to them. Whereas the Japanese ones just have a single tone, quite high pitched, just as a polite little horn, because they use it differently than we do over there. So we've got deeper ones over here, and then we have higher pitched ones over here. So these ones are these 500 and 600 hertz. Yeah, so 500 and 600 hertz here, and then we've got just mixers in between.
So before we start, we'll address the Japanese to English translations names of these products. So the most squealiest one is just the PIA Sports Horn. Then we've got the Sports Horn Lightweight Super Horn, which is my personal favourite name. Well done, Mr. PIAA. We've got the Slender Horn Lightweight Super Horn. Again, unrivaled to this one, but great name. And we've got the Sports Horn Super Bass. I'm really excited to hear the Super Bass.
Yeah.
I hope it's bassy.
All about that bass, aren't we?
We are all about that bass. So, yeah, we'll put a clip in here, actually, of what the OEM horn sounds like.
So as part of replacing the horn on the GR Yaris, we're going to have to remove the front bumper. So we'll do a quick guide on that as well, just so that you can see it. You don't necessarily have to. I've seen people remove a certain bit of trim, which I'll show you in the video. But if we do that, I won't actually be able to show you anything because my arms will be in there instead. So we'll take the bumper off and I'll point out what you need to change and where it is.
Okay, so what we thought, we'd just unbox one of the horns. We've got the Sports Horn here. Yeah, Sports Horn.
Super Bass.
Super Bass Sports Horn. So yeah, let's just box it and see what's inside. Yeah. And just for reference, they're all the same in the boxes,
aren't they? Yeah, they are. They're a pretty universal kit, so you're not going to see any plugs specific for your car. You can get them on like Amazon or whatever, but everything you need is in here, really.
Let's go. So. There's not much to it, really. Two horns and a cable and some Japanese instructions.
Yeah, we've got some instructions. I think they are in English as well, hopefully. No.
So if you buy one of these horns, you do need to read Japanese to fit it.
They are very simple. There's just a positive and a negative on each one. The negative will just go to a ground. Horns are generally just have one positive wire going to them. If they have two, then you just need to follow your manufacturer's wiring loom guide. It's not rocket science. There's just positive and a negative, and that's it, and it'll work.
Whereabouts do they fit, Matt? Can you see them on your car? Or?
If you're a Subaru owner, you can.
So not on your Yaris?
No, I'm going to fit them a bit tidier, a bit tucked away a little bit behind the bumper. Depends where your standard horn is. Sometimes they are visible, like in front of the radiator. Sometimes they're hidden away. It's totally up to you.
Cool.
But yeah. Okay, so the horn on the GR Yaris is actually hidden behind this top grill. You can just about see it if you look for it, but not really going to be able to see me working on it. So we're just going to take the front bumper off. So this is how you take it off. First thing we're going to do is pop the bonnet, and we've got a couple of bolts under there. So we've got two 10mm bolts under the bonnet, as well as these clips here. You don't need to undo these ones. These four on the top here, those just hold the grill on. So some people say, and I'm no doubt, that you can take this bit of black plastic out from behind the bumper and not do it all that way. However, like I said to you before, I'm not going to be able to show you anything if I do that, because all you'll see is my arms in there, so quicker for me to just take the bumper off. As well as those fixings there, we've just got one connector, and that's for the front badge, which has the camera in it and a load of other good stuff that it uses. So we just need to unplug this connector here. Your airbox won't be in the way if it's standard, but mine is. So there is another connector here, but we don't need to worry about that because it's just this wire all the way through. So it's just this one by this passenger side headlight that you need to undo. The next thing that we're going to do is just take this couple of screws just going up, joining the bumper to the wing. So we're just going to pop the trim clip out that's behind this here, and then that'll we can peel that back and expose that that screw there. Okay, so to help me out with that, for a bit of extra access, I've just moved the wheel over to the left there to help me get access to this right hand side, and then when I do the left hand side, I'll turn the wheel all the way over to the right, just to give me a bit more space to work around this. So there's just a small trim clip in here. And once that's out the way, we can just peel this back a little bit like that and then expose the screw that's just there. And what we can do there, like a lot of modern bumpers, you just give this a good pull away from the car to pop out that corner. Just take a bit more force than you'd like to put into your own car, but it does come away like that. So from the back here as well, we can reach down and unplug our fog light. And then repeat that on the other side. If we look at the corners on each side, we've got three 10mm screws. They go upwards from the front of the arch liner into the bumper, so we need to take those out. So as well as those ones in the corners, we've got four, I believe, 10mm screws up into the sort of the lower rad support. And you can see those, they go on the little white tabs that you can see. Be easier to show you when we've got the bumper off. Right, so now that both corners are disconnected, the top and bottom are disconnected, we can go ahead and pull the bumper off. As long as both the fog lights are unplugged, we've got this connector off unplugged there. There's nothing else that's holding the bumper on. Right, now that we've got the bumper off, let's just have a quick recap of where all those fittings are so that you know when you take them off. As you've seen, I haven't bothered jacking the car up. Unless your car's super low, you don't really need to get the bumper off one of these. So we have one of these fittings in each corner. These are all 10mm fittings, by the way. So we've got one there, we've got one on the other corner, just here. We have three fittings in each corner, another three there. And then we have four fittings across the middle. And then lastly, we have the four that we took off from underneath the bonnet. Now, as you can see, these clips here, these top four clips, they don't need to come out. They're just there to hold the grill onto here. So the connections wise, we've got one here, which connects to the front badge, which has a camera in, et cetera, et cetera. We've got one for the fog light this side, and we've got one the other side as well. So we've got three electrical connections, and then all the other screws that I mentioned there. And then that's it. Pull the sides out, as I showed you, pull it off. Do take care, because these are thin bits of plastic. It can be easy to damage them if you pull them the wrong way. I've made that mistake before, but yeah, as long as you pull them the right way, that's it. Pop them out, pull the front bumper off, job's a good one. Right, so now that the bumper's off, this is the standard horn location. It's held on by one bolt there. It's like it's a 12 or a 13mm, probably 12mm. That's the earth for the horn. The positive feed is provided by this single plug connector that's just plugged into the side of the horn here. So this is the one we're going to be using to power all the other horns that we plug in. So you can just use this standard bracket here if you want to. I've actually made up a little bracket. As long as it fits in this sort of confinement here, you're going to be absolutely fine. Some people have put them up on top as well. whatever you feel comfortable with, but personally I want them hidden away in the factory location, ideally with the ends pointing down away from any water ingress, things like that. So with that said, we'll get the super bass horn on first and give it a try. We're not going to bother putting the bumper on between sound runs because it doesn't affect the sound, so you have to excuse the fact that it hasn't got a bumper on, but yeah, we'll get on with that, we'll get it fitted and we'll get a sound test. And that's it, that's the factory horn removed, just the one bolt holding it on. As I say, it just earths through its actual bracket here, so we'll save that bolt, so we'll need it, and then we'll bolt the other horns on. So it's not strictly necessary, you can just use the standard fixing point there, but I have made myself another bracket here just to make sure that they're sort of held in the orientation that I want. So we're going to fit this bracket to the car. I'm going to make sure that it earths out correctly so we can continue using this as an earth point.
Okay, so we've just tested the PIAA, is it PIAA?
No, it isn't.
We've just tested the PIAA horns. Matt, what have you gone for?
I've just gone for the middle of the road, boring, sounds like every German car on the road, this one.
Good choice.
It's not boring really, it just sounds like a normal horn that it should have come with from the factory.
Yeah, it's pretty OEM, isn't it?
Yeah.
The bass horn,
yeah,
super bass horn. That was a little bit like,
Really was quite aggressive, wasn't it?
Yeah.
This
one sounded pretty similar. Was it this one?
Yeah, these. So these ones are the same frequency. So if you don't know about the frequency, the Hertz rating, how many times it's vibrating per second, the higher it is, the higher pitch you'll hear. So that's why this one at 300 and 400 is lower in sound than that one, which is 500 and 600.
Yeah, I mean, that one will bully people out of the way.
Yeah, I'd feel a bit embarrassed pressing the horn, having the noise that this thing came out with,
yeah,
and then following up with a Yaris being there. You'd expect some horn tank or something,
yeah,
wouldn't you?
Yeah.
But that one was a bit too far.
This one's a joke horn. It's an actual joke horn.
Again, I wouldn't feel like I'd conveyed the right message if I beeped that.
I mean, this was probably worse than OEM, arguably.
Yeah, I wouldn't like to have spent, I don't know,
45 quid.
Yeah.
You press that and everyone just laughs at you.
Yeah.
I mean,
I think these ones are the ones to go for. This one, if you really do mean business and you want people to get out of the way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That sums it up. And thank you again, Matt, for coming down. Go check out our other Yaris exhaust video, intake video. Any other guys you want to see, let us know in the comments. Like this video, subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.